Welcome here today as we celebrate this Feast of Pentecost. Here in Toowoomba and around Australia, it's a time when we are feeling colder, and yet we also celebrate Pentecost as the fire of the Spirit within us. So let your hearts be warmed. Let your life be filled with that fire of love which we have from God. And let this be a time to draw closer to God and to feel God's presence, to be inspired by God as we join together in prayer.
Sancte Spiritus,
Veni, Sancte Spiritus, Veni, Sancte Spiritus, Veni, Sancte Spiritus,
Come, Sancte Spiritus,
Veni, Sancte Spiritus.
Disperse the shadows over us, renew and strengthen your people.
Veni, Sancte Spiritus, Veni, Sancte Spiritus, Veni, Sancte Spiritus, Veni, Sancte Spiritus. Sancte Spiritus, Veni, Sancte Spiritus, Veni, Sancte Spiritus,
Via Sancta Sancte Spiritus, Lumiera,
et
Sancta Spiritus,
Veni, Sancte Spiritus, Veni, Sancte Spiritus, Veni, Sancte Spiritus, Veni, Sancte Spiritus, Veni Sancte Spiritus, Veni Sancte Spiritus, Veni Sancte Spiritus, Veni Sancte Spiritus,
Komm, Sancte Spiritus. Lass den Glanz deines Herrlichkeit vom Himmel erstrahlen. Veni Sancte Spiritus,
Veni Sancte Spiritus, Veni Sancte Spiritus, Veni Sancte Spiritus, Veni Sancte Spiritus, Veni Sancte Spiritus,
Veni Sancte Spiritus.
Welcome to St. Luke's Anglican Church this morning for this celebration of the Feast of Pentecost. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. By his great mercy, he has given us a new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. The collect for this Feast of Pentecost. Almighty God, at the Feast of Pentecost, you sent your Holy Spirit to the disciples, filling them with joy and boldness to preach the gospel. Empower us with that same spirit to witness to your redeeming love and draw all people to you through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We join in a prayer of thanksgiving. Gracious God, we humbly thank you for life and health and safety, for freedom to work, leisure to rest, and for all that is beautiful in creation and human life. But above all, we praise you for our Saviour, Jesus Christ, for his death and resurrection, for the gift of your Spirit, and for the hope of sharing in your glory. Fill our hearts with all joy and peace in believing, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please join with me now as we sing our next hymn to that great tune, Jerusalem, Great God, Your Spirit Like the Wind.
Thank you.
invite Anne Merson to read for us our first reading from the Acts of the Apostles.
A reading from Acts chapter 2, verses 1 to 21. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. And suddenly, from heaven, there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues, as of fire, appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear each of us in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs, in our own language we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power." All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk, as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy, and I will show portents in the heaven above and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." Hear the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
We now have Psalm 104, verses 26 to 36, being read for us in a variety of different languages.
Que tes œuvres sont un grand nombre, ô Éternel, tu les as toutes faites avec sagesse, la terre est remplie de tes biens.
Hoc mare magnum et spatiosum manibus, illic reptilia quorum non est numerus, animalia pusilla cum magnus.
Alba burde ashan yemsi malabathen rabuna katetu ashan kide aelafu fimoya.
Semuanya bergantung kepadamu untuk mendapat makanan pada waktunya.
When you give it to them, they gather it. When you open your hand, they are satisfied with good things.
Vergibst du dein Angesicht, so erstrecken sie. Nimmst du ihren Odem weg, so vergehen sie und werden weiter zu Staub.
तर हे परम प्रभु जब तपाईले आफ्नो आत्मा पठाउनु हुन्छ अनि तिनीहरू स्वस्थ हुन्छन् अनि तपाईले फेरि भूमि नयाँ बनाउनु हुन्छ.
Nek do veka bude slava Gospodnja. Nek delima svojim raduje se Gospod.
Ho, epi blepon, epi ten gen,
kai poion oton tremain, ho aptomenos ton oroon kai kapnitzotai.
I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will praise my God while I have any being.
Ne tang yan attack, ye miet in on in. And be pure yala yum ni yokoba.
I now invite John Stanley to read for us our second reading from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians.
A reading from St. Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 12, verses 1 to 13. Now concerning spiritual gifts, brothers and sisters, I do not want you to be uninformed. You know that when you were pagans, you were enticed and led astray to idols that could not speak. Therefore, I want you to understand that no one speaking by the Spirit of God ever says, "Let Jesus be cursed," and no one can say, "Jesus is Lord," except by the Holy Spirit. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. There are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To another faith by the same Spirit. To another gifts of healing by the one Spirit. To another the working of miracles. To another prophecy. To another the discernment of spirits. To another various kinds of tongues. To another the interpretation of tongues. All these are activated by one and the same Spirit, who allots to each one individually, just as the Spirit chooses. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ. For in the one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and we were all made to drink of one Spirit. Hear the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Please join with me as we sing together, Holy Spirit, Living Water.
Oh,
Whipple will now read for us a reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John, chapter 20, beginning at the 19th verse. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. John, chapter 20, beginning at verse 19. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." Hear the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. We now have a response to the gospel sung for us by some of the girls from the Glennie School. Please join me in this affirmation of faith. We believe in one God, who made and loves all that is. We believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was born, lived, died, and rose again, and is coming to call all to account. We believe in the Holy Spirit, who calls, equips, and sends out God's people, and brings all things to their true end. May I speak in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. When people say they do something in the spirit of, what does this mean? When people say that something is in the spirit of someone, or in the spirit of a place, or in the spirit of a type of cuisine, or artistic style, or political ideology, what do they mean? One definition which I found online suggested that we mean that something we are referring to is the general or real meaning of the other thing to which connection is being made. It is also possible to hear that phrase in the spirit of as if it meant something which was a shadow, a pale image, a lesser expression of the other thing. Another online suggestion was that this expression means along the lines of, which could be just vaguely like. A definition of this phrase which resonates with me, though, was that it means honouring. When we do something or express something in the spirit of a particular person or situation or context or content, then what we are doing is showing honour by wanting to make that connection and by doing what we do in a way that honours the original person or situation. When people have prayers using Taizé music around the world, often they are asked to say that it is in the spirit of Taizé, and in that sense, it means that connection of honouring. A final definition which I found suggested that to get into the spirit of something was to enter into that thing with enthusiasm. I like that one too. Why was I doing this internet searching? And more importantly, why am I talking about that here? It is because today we are celebrating the Feast of Pentecost, the birthday of the church, the day when semi-literate fishermen startled crowds of people on their way to celebrate a religious festival with a message which rocked their socks off. And so many people do, when confronted with something which challenges their worldview, some in the crowd dismissed the men and their message. They even said that these guys, only men are mentioned getting up to speak here, that these guys were drunk. A shocking thing, since it was early morning and everyone knew that properly pious people would always finish their day's work before hitting the bottle. There was a long tradition that when a messenger gave a distasteful or disturbing message, then they would be disregarded or executed for having the audacity to utter something which the hearer didn't want to hear. We have that still in the plea, "Don't shoot the messenger." On this day, the disregard came through mockery. Later, as many Christians have found over the past 2,000 years, the rejection of the message went as far as executing the one who was sharing it. Peter and the disciples got that treatment from some this day. Jesus often encountered that reaction. So why were Peter and the others saying and doing things which made them open to ridicule? They were in the spirit, not in the spirits or the wine, as was suggested. They were in the spirit of God. We look at the readings this day, and we see in them often the operation of some external force, the Spirit of God, acting on and then through the followers of Jesus. To be able to share in that seems then to require that we invite or create the circumstances through which the Holy Spirit of God will shake us up and transform us too, from outside reaching in to change us. And if that doesn't happen, If we don't get inspired, if we don't feel ourselves being transformed, then something has gone wrong. And either we messed up the invitation, or God has chosen not to bless us with that particular experience. I want to invite us to look differently today, and for as long as you have breath, at what it means to be in the Spirit. For anyone who may hear or read this and begin preparations for a heresy trial, in which I may be charged with denying the existence of the third person of the Holy Trinity, please hear me out. And if you still want to string me up, you know where to find me. Throughout the Old Testament, when we find references to the Spirit of God, what is being described is a way in which God's presence is expressed. See the references to Spirit in Genesis 1 and 2, and also in Ezekiel 37, remembering as you read those that the word for breath and the word for Spirit that are used there are the same word. That becomes even more important when we look at the gospel reading today, and Jesus breathes on his disciples and says, "Receive the Holy Spirit." In Isaiah 42 and Psalm 143, and in many places throughout the Old Testament, the Spirit of God is a source of life and wisdom and encouragement. To be in the Spirit is to be touching the life of God and to find new life. We see that in that passage from Acts chapter 2, verses 1 to 21, where Peter and the others spoke about the love and invitation and actions of God. They were sharing a new and renewed perspective on life, not as a piece of philosophy to chew over, but as an experience which shines light on everything else. That is what Jesus was giving, breathing into the frightened and still stumbling disciples in that locked upper room. It was far more than some physical transfer of essence through breathing on them. Jesus was inviting them and us to be transformed. To be in the Spirit of God, are we seeking to be, at least perhaps sometimes, a shadow of the real thing? We may feel like that, but that is not what is offered. To be in the Spirit of God, we are invited to be connected to what is most real about God, absolutely. To be in the Spirit of God, are we being invited to be people who are transformed in ways which will mean that we honour God in who we are, what we say, how we think and act and speak? Again, absolutely. This is what is breathed into us, that opportunity, that invitation, the strength to be able to express in our lives the life of God. Is that not mind-blowing? Is that not enough to rock your socks off too? Or your slippers, if that's what you're sitting there wearing? You want Pentecost to happen? Be prepared for the life of God to be expressed in you. Be prepared for the love of God to be expressed in you. How will that happen? That's part of the divine beauty in all of this. It will happen with a cosmic continuity, but also differently in each of us. That's what Paul was pointing out in the reading from the first letter to the Corinthians today. Being in the Spirit is not one size and shape and expression fits all. Just as we are different, how God's love and life is expressed in and through each of us will be different, drawing on the strengths of the character and capabilities which we have been developing individually since we each first drew breath, drawing on the opportunities of place and time and context in which we each live, drawing on the myriad of languages we speak, and even on the peculiarities of the different ways in which we each express humour. All of these differences between you and me will find expression in the different ways in which God is expressed in and through us. In that richness, we also see the birth of the church, for which this is our birthday, because it is only when we recognize that we, each and every part of we, have something to offer, and that we are less when we don't honor each other as we honor God. It is when we recognize that we are called into community as a community, we will be able to learn to be communally in the Spirit of God. To be in the Spirit is to be touching the life of God and to find new life together. So be inspired, be encouraged, be fired up with the possibility of what God is and has been and will be doing in and through you, every one of you, and through us together. Amen. Which doesn't mean putting a full stop and bringing those thoughts to an end, but amen intentionally lights a flame in your reflecting on all that we are sharing this day. Sit with those reflections about honouring God in who you are and enter into that with enthusiasm. Amen.
I've got peace.
enter now a time of confession, of honesty before God. Let us pray together. Our God, we come in humility, confessing who and what we are. We are often unresponsive, for we are afraid. When your Spirit speaks, we turn deaf ears, for we fear what you might call us to do. When your Spirit touches our lips, we close our mouths, embarrassed to speak your word. When the wind of your Spirit blows, we close the windows of our hearts, afraid the breeze will disrupt our ordered lives. When the fire of your Spirit touches us, we quench the flame, afraid of the new life it might bring. Forgive us, O Lord. Lord God, touch and turn and inflame our hearts. Burn away all that is not holy, and from the fire inspire and cleanse and renew us. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, be renewed, cleansed and forgiven. Amen.
Come and pray in us, Holy Spirit.
We join together in the prayer which Jesus taught his friends. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. I now invite John Compton to lead us in prayer.
Intercessions today for Pentecost Sunday. The response to the intercessionary prayers will be, Come Holy Spirit, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, in whom we trust that nothing will separate us from you, grant that your Holy Spirit may in all things direct and rule our hearts. Hear our prayers for the world and for the church. We pray for the leaders of nations and for all in authority. Guide with your wisdom and power the leaders of nations so that people may live in peace and trust, sharing with justice the resources of the earth. Give the people of this land a spirit of unselfishness, compassion and fairness in public and private life, as we confront the challenges of recovery to restore our lives, workplaces, and economy. Particularly at this time, we pray for all in authority with responsibility for protecting their people in recovery from the COVID-19 virus. We pray for scientists and researchers around the world as they strive to develop a successful vaccine. Come, Holy Spirit, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the preservation of the earth. We give thanks for the beauty and abundance of the earth. We give thanks for the rain received and pray for further falls to bring relief from drought, that people may receive the means to sustain them and their communities. Give us and all people grace to live in harmony with your creation, wisdom and generosity in use of its bounty. Come, Holy Spirit, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the church and its mission. We give thanks for the ministry team and resources we have in this parish to support your church's mission. We pray for the people in the congregations in the parish of St. George Dirumbandi, that they will recover from drought to rejoice with us in shared ministry. We pray for Paul and Peter and their families. Sustain them in their ministries, as we also pray for all ordained and lay people who share ministry in this parish. Strengthen us for our work in the world to proclaim the gospel in service, word, and sacrament. Come, Holy Spirit, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for ourselves and our community. We give thanks for our families and the fellowship of the communities in which we live and work. We pray for those who love and support us and for our responses to them. We commend to your keeping ourselves and each other, our families, our neighbours and friends. Particularly at this time, we pray for frontline health workers and carers who are attending to the needs of patients, the elderly and those in care. Enable us by your Spirit to live in love for you and for one another. Come, Holy Spirit, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For those in need, we give thanks that you are the God who brings mercy and wholeness. We pray for those needing healing, support, and comfort in suffering at this time. Particularly, we pray for the unemployed seeking work as a result of business closures and staff reductions due to the impact of the pandemic, that they will be supported in their need and for our response when challenged. Comfort and heal, we pray, all who are in sorrow, need, sickness, or any trouble. Give those who care for them wisdom, patience, and gentleness. Come, Holy Spirit, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the faithful departed. We give thanks, Lord, for your servants in every age, particularly those known to us who have gone before in our families and in this parish. Grant that we, with all your saints, may be brought to a joyful resurrection and the fulfillment of your kingdom. Almighty God, you have promised to hear our prayers. Grant that what we have asked in faith, we may by your grace receive through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you, John, and all of those who have read and shared and been part of the service today. Loving God, we thank you for hearing our prayers, feeding us with your word, and encouraging us in our meeting together. Take us and use us to love and serve you and all people in the power of your Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please join with me as we sing together our final hymn, Filled with the Spirit's Power.
Thank you.
for being here with us today. I hope that this has been a time of inspiration and enthusiasm. If you would like to join us for our gatherings, then please register with our parish office and as many people as we are allowed to have with us when we broadcast these services. We will ask to be able to be here and we will let you know where we will be. But please register with our parish office. God, stir up within you the gift of the Spirit, that you may confess Jesus Christ as Lord and proclaim the joy of the everlasting gospel wherever you may be. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, amen. Thank you for joining together with us in prayer. I hope that this time of worship together has encouraged you and inspired you, and that you recognize the presence of God with you, that embrace of love and the power of the peace that God gives us to be able to live our lives and to know that we are loved, and then in time to be able to share love ourselves. May this be a day of peace for you as you look forward. Please continue to join with us in prayer. Amen.